Hello there again. Welcome back to our video series of practical science projects. Okay, so to dive right in, today we are going to do something really exciting, and that is basically learning how to charge a capacitor. As unexciting as that might seem, actually there are so many practical applications of this particular process of charging a capacitor. What underlies the operation or the smooth functioning of your keyboard is actually a process of, you know, this particular process right here, which is charging and then discharging of a capacitor. So this particular video is dedicated to helping us understand how charging a capacitor works, so that you can have an insight into how, you know, keyboards actually function. Only components you need to charge a capacitor are your battery or the source of energy that you're going to use to charge the capacitor and the capacitor itself. But because we are demonstrating how the charging process works, we'll be needing a resistor, as you can see over there. We'll be needing, of course, the capacitor itself, and then a light emitting diode, so that we have a visual sort of look at how the charging process actually takes place. So the components we'll be needing are essentially our capacitor. This is basically called an electrolytic capacitor, and it's essentially the type that is one directional. We have different types of capacitors, and within the science set, you're provided with two types. The first one is an electrolytic type, and then the other one is a ceramic type. For the ceramic type, it's like the resistor in the sense that it doesn't depend on how you connect it. But with the electrolytic one, which is the one we are going to use for this demonstration, it is unidirectional, which means that you have to connect it in the right order. So as you can see from the board, the positive end should be connected indirectly to the positive terminal of the battery. And as you're already familiar with, we have a resistor that we need to use. We also have our makeshift switch, which I showed you the other time. And what we are going to do is, because you already learned from the other video how to assemble the circuit all the way from the battery to the switch, and even to the resistor, what we are going to do is we're going to build off of that particular knowledge. So as you can see on this table right here, we have an incomplete circuit that we are about to complete by putting the LED bulb and the circuit and then the resistor, joining all these other components to the incomplete one we have on the table. So as you can see right here, we have our battery, which has been fully connected for us, and then our switch. So yeah, we will just dive in to the process of building this circuit. We are going to go through the process of connecting the resistor, the capacitor, the LED bulb, and then finally complete the circuit. So to connect the resistor to this incomplete circuit we have over here, you just grab the open end of the female connecting wire, as you can see right here. And for this particular demonstration, we'll be using the 1 kilo ohm resistor. So you get the 1 kilo ohm resistor from the science set, and then you connect the open end of the female connecting wire to one of the pins on the component boards of the 1 kilo ohm resistor. So having done that, what we do is we grab another female connecting wire, and what we use that wire for is to connect or to join the resistor to the capacitor, right? And you have to remember that the capacitor we are using is a unidirectional one. So it means that we have to connect the positive end to the positive terminal of the battery. So with your female connecting wire, you grab your electrolytic capacitor and you connect that capacitor to the resistor, just as I'm doing right here. So having connected our electrolytic capacitor, we just move on to connect our LED bulb, which, as I said, we'll be using as our visual indicator. Okay, so you grab another female connecting wire so that we can be able to join our LED bulb to our capacitor. As you can rightly see over here, we connect the capacitor to the LED bulb. So yeah, we just connected our LED bulb, and so the very last thing that we have to do is basically to close the circuit. And closing it in this case is simply connecting the negative terminal of the battery, as you can see, to the negative part of the LED bulb, which we've done 1,000 times already. So yeah, close the circuit by using another female connecting wire, just as we have over here. And this is it. So very gently, you push the component in. Yeah, basically this is the circuit that we are building for today. And you might be asking yourself, why is it that this charging process requires things like an LED bulb, a resistor, and all of these things? They seem unnecessary. That is very true. But we are using our LED bulb as a visual indicator of how the charging process actually takes place. So in this circuit that we have just assembled together, the moment we turn on the, or we close the switch, what happens is that the voltage across the capacitor begins to build up very rapidly to match the voltage across the battery. And when that is happening, it means the current that is flowing through the circuit begins to decrease. And so just as you probably guessed right, the light that is being emitted from the LED bulb should also do what? Should also decrease very rapidly. And so that is what we are going to demonstrate right now. So watch carefully as I close the circuit, because as I close the circuit, the light from the LED bulb will diminish very rapidly. That was basically the visual cue that the current in the circuit was decreasing because the voltage across the capacitor was building up. One thing that I just want us to sort of understand is, so if you look at the graph of the current flowing through the circuit against time, which is in seconds or milliseconds, you basically realize that with the charging process, the current basically goes off very rapidly, and then it goes off towards zero, right? But it doesn't really get to zero, and it takes a very long time, because it's an exponential graph, it takes a very long time for the current to decay all the way to zero. So yeah, this actually brings us to the very end of this video, but to talk about amazing things you can do with this, I will challenge you to actually explore the discharging process for a capacitor. So just think about how you would tweak this little setup we have over here to experiment with the discharging process. So the discharging process is basically where you use the capacitor as your primary source of energy to power your circuit, or to basically to supply current to whatever electrical components you need to supply current to. So yeah, that is another fun thing you can do and explore on your own. And for those who are more mathematically like inclined, what you can do is you can actually get a timer and then start the timer as you turn the circuit. You basically close the circuit, you turn the timer on, and you basically leave the timer on for however long you want it to, and then you can use that information to be able to calculate how much charges builds up on the capacitor. This is just a fun thing, mathematical thing that you can also explore to know that charges are actually building up on the capacitor. So yeah, this brings us to the very end of our second video.